Now, the second example is of Triticum aestivum. It is a hexaploid situation. Now, we will see. For making the Triticum aestivum, the scientists have taken the two species. One is Triticum monococcum and Aegilops speltoides. These were the two different species which were taken for the formation of the Triticum aestivum. This Triticum monococcum, it was having 2n = 14, it was in the diploid condition, it was having chromosome number 14, and the same in the Aegilops speltoides also, 2n = 14. So at the time of the gamete formation, they released n = 7 and n = 7, and when they cross over each other, they formed one species in diploid condition with 2n = 14. This was the diploid condition, and again same as that of the Raphanus brassica, here also they treated it with the chemical for doubling the chromosome number. For doubling the chromosome number. So, when they treated with the chemical, so here we will take the 1 7 chromosome from here, 2 2 7 pair of the 7 7 chromosomes from the Triticum monococcum, and here also the 2 7 chromosome from the Aegilops speltoides, or we can say that we are taking the chromosome in the 2n situation or in the diploid situation, that 14 chromosomes from the Triticum monococcum and 14 from the Aegilops speltoides. So next, the species what we formed by the combination of these was having 4n = 14. This was the tetraploid condition, and the species which is formed is Triticum durum. The species which is formed is Triticum durum, which is formed by the diploid chromosomes of the Triticum monococcum and the diploid chromosomes of the Aegilops speltoides. The tetraploid condition is formed, or the tetraploid species of the wheat is formed, which is called as Triticum durum. So when this Triticum durum crossed with Aegilops squarosa, this is the species of the same genus, Triticum durum and Triticum squarosa. When both of these were crossed, so Triticum durum ye to 4n condition mein hi hai, 4n = 14, 4n = 28. So Triticum duram is the tetraploid condition which is having 28 number of chromosomes, 4n equals to 28, and Agelops it is having 2n equals to 14. So, when both this species crossed, so at the time of gamete formation, it is 4n equals to 28, so it will be diploid in situation, 2n equals to 14, and it will be haploid, 2n equals to 7. Whatever may be the number or whatever may be the combination, whether it is diploid, it will become haploid. If here it is tetraploid, it will become diploid, and here it is diploid, it will become haploid. So, they released their gametes, and these gametes will now cross over. So, when these gametes cross over, they form the hexaploid situation with the chromosome number 42. They formed the hexaploid situation with the chromosome number 42. Therefore, the triticum astivum is the hexaploid and it is having the chromosome 42, which is formed by the triticum monococcum and by the Agelops speltoidus. 2n equals to 14 and 2n equals to 14. They released gamete and formed one diploid situation, and from this diploid situation they formed a tetraploid situation, that is triticum duram, and this triticum duram when crossed with Agelops squarosa, it is already in the tetraploid situation, therefore it will be released its gamete in diploid situation and here in the haploid situation. So, by the crossing over of this diploid and this haploid, they form the hexaploid situation with the chromosome 42. Therefore, the triticum astivum is a hexaploid and it bears the chromosome number 42. So, this was the concept of the speciation, that how the new species is formed. In speciation, we have studied the two types of speciation, or speciation can take place by two means. The first was gradually speciation and the second was instant or the sudden speciation. In gradual speciation, we again have talked about the two means, that is allopatric type of speciation and sympatric. Allopatric occurs by the geographical barriers when the two species or when the same species were separated by some type of geographical barriers, then it will be called as allopatric speciation. In that, we have talked about the example of the Darwin finches. And in the sympatric speciation, the new species is formed when the same species or when the one species is living at the same geographical area. There was no barrier in the continents, or there was no barrier in the island. They were living on the same place. Then also they formed the new species because of the difference in their ecological niche. And we have talked about the instant speciation. In instant speciation, again there are two means of that. One is mutation. We have studied earlier about the mutation, and hybridization. So, hybridization, when the two different species cross over with each other, then occurs the hybridization. And we have taken the example of the Raphanobrassica and the Triticum astivum in case of hybridization. So, here we have formed a tetraploid species Raphanobrassica, and here we have formed a hexaploid species Triticum astivum, which we are using now. We are eating this wheat now. In the next, we will discuss about the reproductive isolation. Next, we will discuss about the reproductive isolation, or we can say that the role of reproductive isolation in speciation. reproductive isolation. So, what is reproductive isolation? It is the mechanism to check or to prevent the species of or the two different species organism from interbreeding. What is a reproductive isolation? Mechanism to check the organisms of two different species from interbreeding. This is the reproductive isolation, that it is the mechanism. ये एक type का mechanism है जो different species के organisms को interbreed होने से रोकता है, that is reproductive isolation. So, why reproductive isolation is present in the nature? Because to maintain the integrity between the or to maintain the integrity of one species so that it cannot interbreed with the another species. Because agar reproductive isolation hoga, if the two different species were interbreeding, started interbreeding with each other, then this results into the hybridization only, and the hybrid characters sometimes they are useful and sometimes they are not useful. So, generally it goes into the waste, it goes vain because of the reproductive isolation. But sometimes the reproductive isolation is very useful. Why it is useful? Because it accumulates the genetic variation accumulates the genetic variations in the population, accumulates the genetic variations in the population to lead evolution. So, this is what? This is the one advantage of the reproductive isolation. Now, we can say that reproductive isolation are of two types. These are of two types. One is prezygotic type of reproductive isolation, and the second one is postzygotic type of reproductive isolation. These are the two types of reproductive isolation. First, we will discuss about the prezygotic type of reproductive isolation. So, it means that, what is the meaning of prezygotic type of reproductive isolation? Zygote ke banne se pehle जो भी isolations हो जाएंगे, कि zygote नहीं बना है, interbreeding नहीं हुई है, mating नहीं हुई है, तो for the prevention of the forming for the prevention of the formation of the zygote, we have to prevent the mating. So therefore, under this point, we will discuss about the situation that which can prevent the formation of the zygote or interbreeding. तो one such cause is geographical isolation. First is geographical isolation. So, some of the species we can say that are separated by the geographical barriers, as we have talked about the Darwin finches. They are the same kind of species, or they were belonging to the same species. Then also they were separated by some geographical barriers. So due to the separation of the geographical barriers, they were not able to meet. So this can also happen in the two different species, that here we are studying about the factors which can prevent the hybridization. So agar do different species ke beech mein geographical barrier hoga, then they are not able to meet. So this is the first factor to prevent the geographical isolation, to prevent the reproductive isolation. The second one is gametic isolation. We know that the gametes of the different species are also different, and their process of mating is also different. If the lower ones are mating, or the lower class of the animals, they are mating, they are having the external type of fertilization, and in the higher classes they are having the internal type of fertilization. So kuch organisms ka to external fertilization hota hai. So what they do, they have to lend their gametes in the water, or in the external atmosphere, say that in the water, or the frog has lent their gametes in the water. But these are not attracted, or other animals are not attracted towards these kind of gametes. Why they will do external fertilization by attracting towards these kind of gametes? So this is the another situation, or the another point which can prevent the reproductive isolation. The third one is mechanical isolation. In mechanical isolation means what? That different animals are having different types of their sex organs. Unke paas mein different sex organs rehte hain, and the shape of every sex organ is different, that they cannot fuse with each, all the types of sex organs cannot fuse with each other. So this type of isolation is called as mechanical isolation. Due to the difference in their sex organs, or due to the difference in the sex organs of the two different species, they cannot mate with each other. This is the third factor, mechanical isolation. The fourth one is physiological isolation. Physiological isolation means they are having the difference in their physical activities, or they are having the difference in the different physiological conditions. Some animals can reproduce in the different conditions, and some animals can reproduce in the different physiological conditions. So this is the another example of the reproductive isolation. The fifth one is seasonal isolation or temporal isolation. We know that the time period of for the mating of different animal is different. Some of the animals likes to mate in winter season, while some of the animals like to mate in rainy season or in the summer season. So they are having the difference in their mating period. Up to that, if an organism want to mate with the another one, up to that period that organism's sexual organs are not fully developed, or they had not developed their gametes. So it is a fail of the mating. So this is the another factor. The seasonal isolation is the another factor for preventing the reproductive isolation. The sixth one is behavioral isolation. in behavioral isolation, we can study about the difference in the mating process or difference in the courtship of the animals. अगर किसी एनिमल का मेट होने का तरीका अलग है, वी नो दैट ऑल द एनिमल्स हैव द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मेटिंग सिस्टम. सम हैव द एक्सटर्नल और सम हैव द इंटरनल और सम अदर हैविंग द अनदर टाइप ऑफ मेटिंग सिस्टम. सो इन द बिहेवियरल वी विल देर इज अ डिफरेंस इन देयर मेटिंग सिस्टम और देर इज अ डिफरेंस इन देयर कर्टशिप. सो दिस ऑल्सो प्रिवेंट्स द ऑर्गेनिज्म ऑफ द टू डिफरेंट स्पीशीज फ्रॉम मेटिंग. So these are the six categories or the six factors which prevents the reproductive isolation, and these six factors come under the category of the prezygotic type of reproductive isolation. Means that zygote ke banne se pehle unhe hum mate hone hi nahi de rahe hain. मेटिंग हम होने ही नहीं दे रहे हैं, तो जायगोट कैसे बनेगा. सो दीज आर द फैक्टर्स विच आर कॉल्ड एज प्रीजायगोटिक टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव आइसोलेशन. नाउ वी विल स्टडी द फैक्टर्स ऑफ पोस्ट जायगोटिक टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव आइसोलेशन. इन दिस द फर्स्ट फैक्टर इज इनवायबिलिटी. इनवायबिलिटी मीन्स अब मीन्स इट इज वी आर स्टडिंग इट अंडर द हेड पोस्ट जायगोटिक टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव आइसोलेशन. तो इन पोस्ट जायगोटिक फर्टिलाइजेशन तो हो गया, फर्टिलाइजेशन हो गया, जायगोट बन गया. बट अब देर इज अ इनवायबिलिटी मीन्स दैट फर्टिलाइजेशन हो गया, जायगोट बन गया, पर वो जायगोट जिंदा रहेगा या नहीं रहेगा. अगर वो जिंदा रह भी गया तो दैट विल डेवलप इन टू द वन ऑर्गेनिज्म और इट विल नॉट डेवलप इन टू द वन ऑर्गेनिज्म, बिकॉज इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी दैट द टू स्पीशीज दैट आर मेटिंग ईच अदर दैट विल रिजल्ट इन टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ वन हेल्दी स्पीशीज ओनली. ऐसा कोई जरूरी नहीं है कि अगर दो स्पीशीज विच आर फ्रॉम टू डिफरेंट स्पीशीज और द टू ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच आर बिलोंगिंग टू द टू डिफरेंट स्पीशीज they are if they are mating, so it is not necessary that they will result into the one normal offspring. So this is the factor of inviability ki fertilization ho gaya, zygote ban gaya, but it is not necessary that zygote will be converted into one healthy species or that zygote will be surviving for a longer period of time for further development. So this type of factor is called as inviability, which comes under the post zygotic type of reproductive isolation. The second one is hybrid sterility. Now in this hybrid sterility we are studying this for post zygotic. So reproduction ho gaya, mating ho gayi, फर्टिलाइजेशन हो गया, जाइगोट बन गया, जाइगोट से नए स्पीशीज भी बन गए, दैट इज ऑफस्प्रिंग हैज आल्सो बीन डेवलप्ड एंड दैट ऑफस्प्रिंग इज हेल्दी. बट इज दैट ऑफस्प्रिंग व्हिच इज फॉर्म्ड बाय हाइब्रिडाइजेशन इज दैट सेक्सुअली एक्टिव और इट इज स्टेराइल. तो इट रिजल्ट्स इनटू द हाइब्रिड स्टेरिलिटी. वी आर हैविंग वन एग्जांपल ऑफ म्यूल. That mule is formed by the crossing over of the donkey and the horse. So that mule is the hybrid sterility. It has been formed. There is a success in fertilization. There is a success in development of the zygote and a healthy offspring. But that is hybrid sterility. That organism is sterile. It cannot reproduce and it cannot give rise to the another mule. That is called as hybrid sterile. The third one is hybrid inviability. Now, in the hybrid inviability, the whole organism have been formed or the whole organism have been developed and it has also taken birth. But it is not necessary that the organism or the hybrid which has taken birth, it will live a good life, or it will survive for a longer period of time. So this type of hybrid which take place or which took birth, but they are not surviving for the longer period of time, or they died after their birth only. So these type of hybrids are called as, or this type of production of hybrid is called as hybrid inviability. So these are some factors or the some points for the reproductive isolation, for the controlling of the reproductive isolation. So what is reproductive isolation? A mechanism to check the organisms of two different species from interbreeding. Agar interbreeding ho bhi jati hai, then some are useful and some are not useful. Useful kis tarah se hongi? Because they are maintaining the genetic variability or genetic variations wo environment mein maintain karke rakh rahe hai for the course of evolution. Evolution, dusri species ke janm ke liye they are maintaining the genetic variations. Par jo useful nahi hai, that will be died or that will be disappeared from the environment. So for preventing the reproductive isolation, we are having the two means, that is one is prezygotic and another one is postzygotic. In the prezygotic, we are talking about before fertilization and before the formation of the zygote. There are six factors which have studied, which we have studied under prezygotic: geographical isolation, genetic isolation, mechanical isolation, physiological isolation, seasonal isolation and behavioral isolation. And in the postzygotic, we have talked about three types of factors: inviability, hybrid sterility and hybrid inviability. So this was all about the reproductive isolation.